everyone. I just thought I'd go through some exercises with you online. I'm giving you now homework. So we're working through some of the classical exercises that we do in class. And this week I've set you the 100 to do for homework. So here's some tips just to take you through the levels. Work at your own level. Listen to your body. Let it tell you how you feel. And only go to the level that you feel comfortable with and that we've practiced in class and you know that you can do. So to come down to the mat, remember your postural checks, scan your body, make sure you're standing in alignment first of all, and think about your breathing and your centering that we covered in the last video. So to come down to the floor, you're going to take one leg behind you, use your hands on your legs or your hips as you need to, use them on the floor if you need to, we're building up to going down to the floor with no hands. So take a breath in, as you exhale, lower down to one knee. Then bring the other knee to meet it. Come down onto all fours and then bring your legs around to the side so that you can line yourself up with the front of your mat. So have your feet and knees hip width apart and in parallel. So like where it's standing, but your knees are bent. You want to sit up nice and tall to prepare. Have your hands behind your thighs, just under your knees, and have your elbows wide and your shoulders relaxed. So as you inhale, you're going to come into a C curve. Then as you exhale, take that C curve back, lengthening the arms, and then lower your spine sequentially into the mat, one vertebra at a time, bringing your head down last. So use a cushion if you usually do in class, just under your head, and settle yourself into your mat. So those checks that you're doing standing, on the mat you get better feedback, so you can feel if your pelvis is equal on both sides, the weight going through is equal, and if there's equal weight going through both sides of your ribcage and through both sides of your shoulders. So make sure there's equal weight going through both feet as well, and make sure you've got a little gap under your lower back, or there's less pressure on your lower back on the mat, so that you're in your neutral spine. So you may need a little head cushion if you find that your head is tipped back. Use a cushion just to bring your head and neck in alignment as you are in standing. So level one of the 100, this was the first exercise Joseph Glasses did in his series, and it's just really to get the oxygen flowing around your body. So really starting to warm up your breathing and just to start to pump that oxygen around your body. But you can just use this as a breathing exercise. So level one of the 100 really is just to breathe in for a count of five through your nose and breathe out through your mouth. So think width through your rib cage as you breathe in for five through your nose and exhale for five counts through your mouth. So you're just starting to warm up your breath and send that oxygen around your body. And use this as a form of relaxation. So really nice to do at the end of the day, if you just want to switch off from your day, or just take a few moments out to meditate when you need to. So that's level one. Level two is to bring your arms into play. So with the 100, we pump the arms for a count of five as you breathe in, and for a count of five as you breathe out. And it's called the 100 because we do 100 pumps. So level two then is just to take a breath in. As you exhale, float your arms off the mat. Keeping your elbows straight, you're just going to breathe in for five and out for five. Breathing in, two, three, four, five, and out, two, three, four, five. And you can stay with this level. You're pumping the oxygen around your body by pumping your arms, and you're challenging your spine by moving your arms. So make sure your tummy button is switched on, your dinner switch is on, so that your pelvis and your spine aren't moving and your legs aren't moving. So that's level one, steer your arms and bring your arms back down. Level one with your breathing, level one with just pumping the arms. Alright, level two, we're going to come into a curl up and do the same exercise. So we're bringing in your deep abdominals into this exercise and you're maintaining that movement, that curl up as you pump your arms. So take your arms up to the ceiling, take a breath in. As you exhale, lower your arms down towards the floor, and as you do so, do your little chin tuck first, so nod your chin to your chest without your head coming off the floor. Then
lift your head, neck and shoulders up as you bring your arms down to the floor so they're parallel. Then keeping that position, that curl up, you're going to breathe in for 5 and out for 5. In 2, 3, 4, 5 and out 2, 3, 4, 5. Maintaining that curl up. So if this is your chosen position, you keep going for 100 pumps. If you find that your neck starts to get tired, you can take one hand behind your head and do that for a count of 10 or 20, and then you can change. Otherwise, keep both arms down and keep pumping your arms until you get to 100. Then steer your arms, take a breath in. As you exhale, lower your spine down one vertebra at a time, bringing your arms back up to the ceiling, and then lower your arms back down. So that's your level 2. Level 3, only do if you're feeling strong and if you've done this in class and you've covered it with me and you know that your back's fine. So don't do this if you've got any injuries. Take a breath in. As you exhale, single and then double knee fold both your legs, maintaining that neutral spine so you've still got a little gap under your lower back or less pressure on the mat. So squeeze your heels together but keep your knees apart. So you're bringing in your glutes into this exercise as well, this version of the 100. Bring your arms up to the ceiling, take a breath in. As you exhale, nod your chin, so it's head still on the mat in that first chin tuck. And then lift your head, neck, shoulders off the mat, curl up. We need a lot of dimmer switch, a lot of tummy in this one. And then start to think, inhaling for 5, exhaling for 5. Breathe in, 2, 3, 4, 5, and out, 2, 3, 4, 5. Keep pressing those heels together so you can feel those glutes switching on as well. Now, if you're feeling super strong and you've done this in class and you don't have any back pain, you can take your legs out on a diagonal to further increase that challenge. So your toes are apart, your heels together, and you're really zipping up your legs. You're squeezing your legs together to work those glutes as well. So again, you're going to go for a count of 100. Use your hand behind your head if you need to. And then slow your arms, bring your heels back in, lower your torso back down, and bring your legs down 1 and 2. So that's your 100 level 3. Just to show you what it looks like in the classical mat version, and I don't want you to attempt this at home, bring your arms up to the ceiling. You're going to take your arms back. As you exhale, nod your chin to your chest, curl up, and extend your legs away so they just float off the floor by a few inches, and then you go. So this is a really tough position to hold. There's a lot of work going on in your deep abdominals, and you mustn't attempt it with any pain in your back at all. So lower and come back down. There's a lot of strain on your lower back in that version, so you shouldn't attempt it at home without supervision. Thanks for listening, thanks for watching. Make sure you do your homework, and I look forward to seeing how you get on next week.